Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let's take a look at the new News app in iOS 9. So the News app is new for iOS 9. It's created by Apple. It's part of the default set of apps that you get with your iPhone or iPad. And basically, it's an aggregator that will allow you to view news articles from all sorts of sources over the internet, and it'll put it together in one interface so you can browse through all the news that's important or interesting to you. So if this is your first time running the News app, it's going to start with a series of welcome screens, and it's going to ask you to choose three different news sources or topics that interest you. Now you'll be able to customize this later, so you can quickly pick some just to get started. So you've got several different screens here. You can access each one at the bottom. I right now have the one at the left selected for you, and this is where you go to read your news. It basically takes all the sources you've selected and puts them all together, shows you recent stuff and interesting stuff, and you can scroll through it. Now if you want to read something, you would just tap on the picture or the headline and it will go into that specific article. And now you have the special view where you can read the article. And what you get here really depends upon the source. Some sources will actually go to great lengths to do special things to fit Apple's news format and show things really nicely. Other ones may just show just the text of the article or the text in a picture. So you're going to get different levels of quality here in terms of what you'll be seeing. But for the most part, you're going to get pretty ad-free or just a small number of ads things on this screen. It'll be easy to read stuff. You've also got the ability to bookmark things and like things and share things. So the bookmark function, if I hit that at the upper right, that saves it. And now I'll be able to actually access that later. So we'll take a look and see how this one appears later. If I hit the like button there, the love button, that will tell the News app that it should feature more articles like these on my main For You page. And then the share button has a typical set of share features. You can send links to people through messages and mail and Twitter and things like that. You can add to your Safari reading list or open this in Safari. Every news article has a web page equivalent. And sometimes there'll be more content on the web for some sources, or sometimes you just want to go to the original web page. So you can do that. You can also just add more as extensions become available. Now, in addition to just seeing everything in the For You page, you can go into Favorites and you can actually see the sources you've chosen. So these may be the ones you chose at the beginning. You can use the Edit button to easily get rid of a source, or you could dive down into a source just by tapping on it. So this will show me, it looks just like the For You page, but it'll show me only articles from that one source. And then I can go to Explore, and Explore is the opposite end of that. I can look through suggested channels and suggested topics. It's important to realize there are two separate things here. Channels will be a specific news source, like say the New York Times or something, whereas suggested topics will be things like, you know, social media or politics or health. So if you add a suggested topic, you may see all sorts of articles from all over the place from different sources. And you can scroll down to the bottom here and you can browse more topics. So there's tons of topics. You can dig deep into each one, and you can kind of get a preview here. If I look at science, it's going to show me different science sources, for instance. If I look at news, it'll show me different news sources. Now I can also search for sources. So I use the search button there at the bottom, and I can type something here at the top to search for it. And it'll give me sources that match by name, sources that match by topic, channel name, all sorts of things in here. And I can select one and add it. So for instance, if I want to add Mac Rumors, I can add that from the search screen here. I can also select it and just go directly into it. So this gives me the ability to just see or preview what I would normally get if I looked at the content. Now the last button at the bottom is Saved, and this has two different sections. First are things that I've bookmarked. So you can see there's that article I bookmarked, and I can go back to it. Very handy to be able to do that. So if you see a long article and you want to get to it later or save up some things for some weekend reading, you can do that. You also have History, which will just show you all the different articles that you've looked at recently. so you've got a clear history button in the upper left. But this is great if you read something earlier and you want to refer to it later and you didn't think to bookmark it or anything. You can just go back and see which articles you read.